Hi there again. Welcome to Iron's Wine Talk. This is wine number 27. We have now a red wine made with Nerello Mascalese, which is a black grape variety which is typically grown and indigenous and endemic to Sicily, precisely in the mountains and the volcanic soils of Etna. It's not a DOC, it's an IGT, Indicazione Geografica Tipica, Terre Siciliane, but it is a light-bodied style. As you can see, it is quite pale in style, and it is exactly made in that way in order to extract its aromatic character. This wine is made by Antichi Vinai. If you do remember before, we have tasted a sparkling wine called Nero Mosso, which was made by the same black grape variety, making a white wine which is sparkling, which was amazing in style. You go back to that wine in order to discover the Nero Mascalese white style, which was really, really interesting. This is, I think, another interesting style which Antichi Vinai wanted to produce. They wanted to make a wine which is light-bodied in style, not full, not robust, but when you see the color, you say, this is so pale. Yes, but when you smell it, you get that beautiful aromatic character coming out of Nero Mascalese, plus you get that minerality and the soil of lava coming out, which is so evident. You can just smell a volcano in this glass. It's just amazing how aromatic it is. One of the most aromatic red wines I think I have ever tasted. And when I see this pale glass, I say, wow, what is this? But you would see that this wine is beautiful as it is. And the winemaker wanted to make something which is quite light in style. Antichi Vinai has his Nerano Mascalese, which is really full-bodied in style and very rich. And this style is made for those people who like light-bodied styles, light to medium minus bodied styles. And Etna has obviously altitude. It ranges even up to 1,000 meters above sea level, and that helps give acidity to a wine which is grown in a hot climate. The east part of the volcano is the part where it is much more sunnier, much more drier in style, and that will give more alcohol to the wine. Nerano Mascalese is a late ripener, meaning it ripens late in order to reach its desired sugar levels. In fact, this wine is at 13% alcohol. Vintage 2018, so it is 2 years old for a light-bodied style, still very young, and made in IGT because it is made in a light style and the yields are a bit higher than a normal DOC. But still, the winemaker managed to extract this beautiful aromatic character, which I think I'm really amazed. It literally flabbergasted me when I just put it under my nose. Just amazing. First time I'm tasting this. Normally, Nerello Mascalese is blended with Nerello Cappuccio. There is also another white grape, a grape that is used, that is Caricante, which is quite interesting and mineral as well. And this wine is just 100% Nerello Mascalese, and which the winemaker defines in purezza, in purity. Yeah? And you're just going to smell that. If you want to smell a Nerello Mascalese, here you go. But don't expect something full-bodied and strong. This is something pleasurable, which can even chill, even up to 12 degrees. Just chill for a few minutes in an ice bucket, and the beautiful fruit character and the minerality character will come out amazingly. If you consider this like a full-bodied white as the temperature, it will be really even amazing because the tannins are quite low. And when tannins are low, the mouth-drying sensation felt on gums and teeth, that wine can be chilled. Yes, this wine is has a hot climate, so the alcohol levels would be quite high, controlled by the acidity levels, controlling day and time temperatures, the diurnal range, which will help to give acidity to the wine, including the altitude. The soils of lava will give that minerality to the wine, which you will see on the nose. Amazing. Believe me, ladies and gentlemen, it is so aromatic in lava soils. You will literally say lava. That is the only word that can be descriptive to this wine. In order to give tannin to the wine, to extract a bit of more tannin, there is a way of extracting that. And that way is by a cold maceration, just for a few days, for black grapes. So So when the grapes arrive, they are crushed, they are not pressed, and the skins are in contact with the wine, normally at higher temperatures for more color and tannin. But the winemaker wanted to help with the extraction of its aromatic character and a bit of more tannin by having it a bit of colder temperatures, something like 18, 19 degrees, 15, in order cold soaking maceration, which the French in Burgundy, for Pinot Noir, they call the Acard method. Yes, a method to extract color and tannin from the skins of the grape. But I'm sure that the winemaker wanted to extract the aromatic character and flavor of the wine, because it's not the tannin which is key over here. It is the total Nerello Mascalese. Yeah? This wine is therefore matured only in stainless steel. If you use oak in this wine or other winemaking methods, you're going to ruin this style. In fact, this is only 4 months aged in stainless steel tanks in order to keep the flavors and richness of the grape. Amazing way of creating a soft style of wine. Well done, Antique Vinaigre. On the appearance, extreme pale intensity. If you put your finger underneath, you totally see it. This means it represents a thin skin grape variety, but the winemaker wanted to create a light-bodied style, so shorter time of maceration on the skins. And that helps in order to extract less tannin in the wine and less color. But the color is still ruby. It still not change into garnet. And I think that ruby will be a typical color for this style of wine. When you see mineral wines, normally, with my experience, normally the color starts to go a bit paler in style. So when you see a pale intensity wine, red wine, which obviously is a good quality style, you're going to see that beautiful pale intensity style. Not that deep, because obviously not so much color and tannin was extracted. On the legs, you can see that it represents a hot climate, but they go down slightly more. And that means that is a medium legs. So that would represent a medium level of alcohol. On the nose, extremely pronounced. So we have a pale intensity wine with that extremely pronounced nose. That shows you are extracting Nerello Mascalese at its best. Totally lava, totally mineral, stones, wet stones. So aromatic, ladies and gentlemen. A bit of gunflint I get as well in the style. Red fruits, strawberry, cherry, raspberry, red currants, all the red fruits you can talk of. Red plums, I do get that. Cranberries, a nice with a roast turkey with cranberry sauce for Christmas. Would be perfect. Wow. And if you chill the wine, I'm sure that fruit character will come out even much more. But that mineral, ladies and gentlemen, is literally surprising me how it is totally there. If you want to identify it, it's more like that salty aroma. We don't use salt so much in wine tasting, but when you smell that salty aroma, normally we call that mineral, stony, flinty, representative of terroir characteristics of Sicily within Etna. On the palate, the wine is called Mascalese because it is Mascalese which is the center of attraction. And that's what it is. Totally dry. Acidity medium plus on the high side. You have altitude. So in a hot climate, to get that altitude, you need to give levels of acidity which are quite high. The body is quite medium minus to light bodied in style. The tannins are quite low because it's the fruit character and the aromatic character of flintiness coming out from the lava soils. The finish is quite medium plus on the high side. It's very pleasurable, very smooth, soft, ripe tannins, and it won't literally hit you so much because it's not going to be full-bodied in style. So this wine is suitable for those people who like light-bodied styles. And yes, serving temperature 12 degrees, 12 to 15 maximum, if you want it a bit warmer. Don't serve this wine at 18 degrees, it is too warm because it's quite light-bodied in style, as you can see with the pale intensity, with that beautiful ruby color. You know? To match, well, Food matching, we said, today I made the baked rice. In Maltese, we call it Russell Foreign, with that meatiness and cheese. It's got acidity to cut its saltiness in it. And the meatiness of bolognese within baked rice. I think it will go really, really well. So for tonight, my baked rice will go with a very good Nerello Mascalese, 100% from Antichi Vinai. This winery was introduced in 1877. It has quite a long history of and tradition of winemaking. A place which I will surely visit one day in my life, because I think that these people have really, really good styles of winemaking, which is amazing. Thank you, Marlon Curti. Marlon Curti imports his wines from Ftira Wines. He owns Ftira Wine Cafe in Tashbish, and a truly passionate guy, which you will surely hear of him for the coming days. And he's doing a beautiful wine cellar in the Ftira Cafe in Tashbish. So do pay a visit, and you will find these wines, which are quite not expensive at all. This is inexpensive to mid-price type, but beautiful for people who like light-bodied wines. Thank you very much. I hope you like this wine number 27. Thank you, and have a good day.